In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Come into witness God's body with confidence as our Lord for pardon and sin. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters.
I have been seen in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most piteous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, every virgin, all the angels and saints, and even my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Almighty and merciful God, we must give your faithful offer your right and praiseworthy service. Grant we pray that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. I consider the sufferings of the present to be as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed in us. Indeed, the whole created world eagerly awaits the revelation of the sons of God. Creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but by Him who once subjected it, yet not without hope. Because the world itself will be freed from its slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. Yes, we know that all creation groans and is in agony, even until now. Not only that, but we ourselves, although we have the Spirit as first fruits, grown inwardly while we await the redemption of our bodies. In hope, we were saved. But hope is not hope if its object is sin. How is it possible for one to hope for what he sees? And hoping for what we cannot see means awaiting it with patience and endurance. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mr. Son, the Lord has done marvel for us.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men dreaming. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue is with rejoicing.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has great things for us. We are glad indeed.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the torrents in the southern desert. Those that sow tears shall reap rejoicing.
The Lord has done marvels for us.
Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back rejoicing and carrying their sheaves.
The Lord has done marvels for us. Please all stand.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "All God's divine of God resemble to what I shall like in. It is like a mustard seed, which a man took and planted in his garden. It grew and became a dark swamp, and the birds of the air nested in its branches. He went on to watch and compare the reign of God. It is like his which a woman took to knead into three measures of flour until the whole mass of dough began to rise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ang pag-aari ng Diyos, the reign of God. So, dalawang image mo ang binigyan ng pansin dito, no? Like a mustard seed. Ang butil ng mustasa. Pangalawa, tulad ng yeast, ang pampalsa na lumaki ng tatlong ulit kaysa sa regular na size nito. So, bahagi po na pinapaalala sa atin, muling binibigyan ng pansin ng Pagkapal ang tungkol sa pag-aari ng Diyos. Kumisa nung kasi may difficulty ng pag-aari ng Diyos, no? Ay katulad po ng ipinahayag yung nakikita yung pag yung kasalukuyang kahirapan kaysa doon sa darating na kaluwalhatian. Kaya po yung sinabi ni Saint Paul on the first reading on his letter to the Romans, ano sabi niya, "I consider the suffering of the present to be as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed." So, nandoon yung contrast between the suffering of this day and the glory of tomorrow, which we will inherit the kingdom of God. Kaya pinahagi niya po rito yung pinakahuling pag-usap. Ano sabi, "In hoping for what we cannot see means awaiting it with patient endurance." Hoping for what we cannot see means awaiting it with patient endurance. Yung paghihintay daw sa mga bagay na hindi natin nakikita ay isang pagpapasensya na kinakailangan natin tiisin. Yun po yung isang bahagi ng pagkilos. Pero mayroon pong pangalawang bahagi ng pagkilos. Na kung tinignan po natin ay siya binibigang pansin yung po tema ngayon na International Eucharistic Congress to be held in Cebu next year ay makikita niyo po, nakalagay po dyan na pamphlet ay ang pinakatema ay to him in the hope ay, in hope the glory. Na kung saan ay the hope of glory, the hope of our glory, ang pag-asa ng ating kadakilaan, to hope our glory, to hope our glory. Na binibigyan pa rin na yung Eucharist, the Holy Eucharist, yung binadiriwang natin ngayon sa araw na ito, what we are celebrating now is the hope of our Lord. It is, kung may tao ng mga hindi naniniwala, it is something that we cannot see. Kasi yung nakikita natin ay yung simply a celebration. Nandiyan ng pare, nagkasalita yung pare, binabasa yung gospel. We have the gospel reading, we have the readings of the Old and New Testaments, no? And then we have the what we believe as being made present in the Holy Eucharist, the Last Supper. Sa mga hindi po mga mananampalataya, it's simply a right for those who do not believe. But for those who believe, it is our hope and of glory. Why? Because Christ is being present here in now. The salvation of mankind is being present here and now. Sinabi ko kahapon na Pope Francis highlighted the element of celebration. So not because it is simply a celebration, but because it is the celebration of our hope in glory. So, bahagi ng pagkilos na kung saan ay nakikita natin. Kaya, yung ating pananampalataya is not only a remembrance of what was happened 2,000 years ago, or it is simply the coming of God's glory to the life of God. But it is here being present in our midst, our hope in glory. In the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. So kaya ang sabi na ako natin, sana po ay maramdaman natin na tulad na parabola na ipinigay ni Jesus, no? Tulad ng isang butil ng mustasa, the seed. Napakaliit. Baka akala natin eh walang reference to any person or to anyone. Pero nandito ang Diyos na nagliligtas, the God who saves. So bahagi mo na kung saan ay maramdaman natin Yung isang elemento po na ipinigay po ng Talinaga ay yung pampaalsa. Yung ipinangayo po na kung saan ay makita po natin yung higit na pagkilos ng pag-ahari ng Diyos. Sa ngayon, mismo na nakikita natin na nawa po ay higit namin pakinabangan sa pag-araw-araw ng pagkilos. Kaya yung patuloy na amo na pag-ahari ng Diyos ay sabi nga po natin ay to recognize the presence of God in our lives. Makita natin ang pag-ahari ng Diyos sa gitna natin. And the 54 Eucharistic Congress would like you, would like us to see God in every celebration of the Holy Mass. It is our hope and glory. Nanasa every time na tayo nag-iriwang ng banal ng Misa, nakikita natin yung patuloy na pagliligtas ng Diyos sa atin. So ngayon, iniligtas tayo ng buong may kapal. So ito yung patuloy namin bigyan po ng pagkapal ka. Sa mas kaliwanag natin pagtugon sa biyaya na ibinagkakaloob sa atin ang buong megapag. Yung po muna ang makita natin kasi once we fail to see the presence of Christ in our midst. No? Sabi nga po ay maramdaman muna natin, ha? Nandito ka pala Panginoon. Nandito ka pala Panginoon. Kasi why? Kasi when we fail to see the presence of Christ, we cannot feel His kingdom. We will not be able to see how a master seed, not a kid, could really bring salvation to each and every one of us. Yun po muna yung una. We have to understand and we have to feel Christ is being made present in our lives. Kahit na ulo sa gitna ng ating katatayuan, sa gitna ng ating kapulangan, in the midst of our littleness, in the midst of our unworthiness, paano pumunta sa atin ang Diyos? Sino pa na tayo para dalawin ang ating Panginoon? Pero we cannot see the kingdom of God unless maramdaman muna natin that He is present here and now. Sa maraming pagkakataon, sa banal na Eucharistia, kung mapapansin mo natin sa kanyang salita na ating binasa, sa kanyang lingkod na pari, sa bawat isa sa atin, nararamdaman ba natin yung presensya ng Diyos? Kaya pumutulusin mo, napakayaman ng mensahe na ipinibigay ko ng International Eucharistic Congress. Ay sinasabi ko sa inyo, kung kayo ay mayroong kakayanan, ay patuloy kong ibinibigyan ng paanyaya. Bagamat sometimes it is costly and it will require you 7 days, not 7 days, 8 days. Kasi Sunday to Sunday, kung makikita po natin, sisimula ng talaga 8 straight days. Ngayon po, hindi ko alam na kasi ito siya ng September, ay alam po yung which is the hope of our glory. Kaya nga, kung makikita po natin, kung nandiyan yung elemento na ibinayad po ni St. Paul, na patient endurance, when kung tayo ay nagtitimpi na gumawa ng kasamaan sa pagkakalam natin, na dahil nandiyan sa Jesus, ayun, isa halimbawa na po, kaya tayo gumagawa ng mabuti, magsisikap tayo huwag gumawa ng kasamaan, dahil kung isa hindi natin nakikita pa yung epekto, nandiyan yung presensya ng Diyos. So, pero yun yung panyaya na ipinapahayo ng buong may kapal. Maramdaman natin our hope of glory. Kaya kung tayo ay natatakaran sa pagdating ng panghari ng Diyos, ay pinapahalan lang sa atin araw, ay nandiyan, makita po natin, nandiyan ang ating Panginoon, Jesu Cristo. Kaya yun po yung patuloy na hamon na ibinibigay mo sa atin. What is Christ in our daily lives? Our hope of glory. At yung bagay na ibinibigay mo ngayon kay Ino, nakita mo ba si Jesus? Ngayon, umamaya, sa loob ng banal na pagdiriwang ng misa. At pwede mong masabi na, deeply within yourself, I have seen the Lord. I have encountered the Lord. I have communed with our God. Our hope of glory. Please allow me also to celebrate the sacrament of confirmation for our brothers who will receive it today. Since we cannot join you for our confirmation this coming Saturday because of other schedules which needed for this coming Friday. Please come forward, brother, with your ninong and ninang. Sa likod po yung kanilang ninong at ninang. To confirm support. In our day, the baptism of the Holy Spirit and confirmation is no longer marked by the gift of tongues, but we know He is coming by faith. He fills our hearts with the love of God, bring us together in one faith but in different vocations, and works within us to make the church one and holy. The gift of the Holy Spirit which you are to receive will be a spiritual sign and sail to make you more like Christ and more perfect members of His church. At this baptism, by John Christ himself was anointed with the Spirit and sent out on his public ministry to set the world on fire. You have already been baptized into Christ, and now you will receive the power of the Spirit and the sign of the cross on your forehead. You must be witnesses before all the world who is suffering death and resurrection. Your way of life should at all times reflect the goodness of Christ. Christ gives varied gifts to His church, and the Spirit distributes them among the members of Christ's body to build up all the people of God in unity and love. Be active members of the church alive in Jesus Christ. Under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, live your lives completely in the service of all, as did Christ, who came not to be served, but to serve. So now, before you receive the Spirit, I ask you to renew the profession of faith you made in baptism. All your parents and grandparents made a union with the whole church. Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Giver of life, who came upon the house of St. Pentecost, and today is given to you sacramentally in confirmation? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the domain of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of body and life and everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. My dear friends, in baptism, God the Father gave the new word of eternal life to His chosen sons and daughters, and us pray to our Father that He will pour out the Holy Spirit to strengthen His sons and daughters with His gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you, and with you, and also with you. My dear friends, let us be one in prayer to God our Father, so we are one in faith, hope, and love that His Spirit gives. For every prayer, let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer. Please repeat.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those sons and daughters of God, firm with the gifts of the Spirit, that they may give witness to Christ by lives built on faith and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parents and grandparents who led them in faith, that with the word of example they may always encourage them to follow the way of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church of God in union with Francis, our Pope, with Aventura Bishop, and all the bishops that God, who gathers us together with our Spirit, may help us to in unity in faith and love until His Son returns in glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all men of every race and nation, that they may acknowledge the one God as Father, and is the bond of the common brotherhood, seek His kingdom with His peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, You sent Your Holy Spirit upon the apostles, and through them and their successors, You give the Spirit to Your people. May His work begun at Pentecost continue to grow in the hearts of all who believe. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So, palakpakan po natin si Edgar for receiving the gift of Offertory.
For the praise and glory of His name, for our
Sione di Guzman and family. Thanksgiving, Sister Beth Nagar. Personal intention for the family and Elizabeth Cuenco and family. For the eternal repose of his sons, Jenelyn Moyuena at Midai. Though we pray, O Lord, for the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is only right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we all sing the hymn of your glory. Without them, we acclaim. Mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give you thanks that you have led us to work in the vain of presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we become into one with the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, Benaventura, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, who all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be poisoned in our life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
In our Lord Jesus Christ, our Father.